Hey, it's me on the way from work again. It's Tuesday. I'm going to just call this inspiration a little minute that I'm going to share with my warriors for freedom out there. Freedom from addiction, freedom from pornography, freedom from illicit affairs, freedom from impure thoughts, freedom from the bondage, the noose of addiction that has wrapped around many of our necks and around my neck for over 50 years of my life. But today I can thank God that it's free. And so I want to let you know that it's time. It's time to rise above the deceit and the mediocrity of our existence. Okay? It's time, men, to get in the word. It's time to do the work of a soldier and come clean. Ask for forgiveness and allow the Holy Spirit to do surgery on your inner man. It's time for the real work to begin. Are you ready? Are you ready to move past the veil? Are you ready to remove the rubble of sin piled up in front of your heart's door? Our cluttered minds now released to the King of Kings, the healer, the one and only one that can deliver us. It's time today, guys. I used to die on the inside every single day. I would imagine myself doing great exploits for the Lord. I would hunger for His anointing on my life. Then I would reflect back on my failures, on my disappointments in myself. I would remember my sin and my lies and my deceptive behavior, and I would crumble from the inside out and retreat back into my addiction. This process would happen over and over and over again. When I heard an inspiring sermon, when somebody pointed out my talents and my ability, when my wife would say she believed in me for a moment, I would believe there was hope for me. Then I would fall. I would find myself looking again, having impure thoughts again, lusting again, masturbating again, this time after being free from addictive behavior for months and even years. I knew that day was coming. The enemy would tell me that day was coming, and I would be immobilized by fear. I would lose heart and lose energy, and apathy would settle in. Have you been there? I would tell myself, it's past your time. You're too old. Nobody wants to hear from you. Your testimony will be ineffective, and God can't use you anymore. Have you ever heard those voices in your head, camouflaged as your own voice? That we know that those are seeds planted by the evil one. You're past your prime, useless, sinful, and washed up. And I would believe the lies. Are you tired? It's time to change. It's a time for a change today. Don't delay. Brother, don't you dare do that. Take it from me. You won't feel better. The high is elusive, and sin, when it is finished, always brings forth death. Being and feeling like a lost soul is the place where the enemy wants us all to be. Feelings of worthlessness, lying thoughts, betraying themselves as reality are the weapons that he uses. Our only defense, and definitely the best offense, is to immerse ourselves in God's word, to be a word man, to spend time listening to God through his word. It sounds simple, but it will be the most testing and trying thing that you will do. Most of my life, I have struggled with staying consistent in my reading of the word of God. I have an addictive personality, they say, so I now use it positively in his word. I'm addicted to God's word. Are you? That's an awesome tool. Try it. Get addicted to the word of God today. As an adult, it is mandatory for me to feed on the word of God. That's the only way my mind's transformation is going to happen. That's my medicine. That's vitamins for my soul. That's nutrients for my beingness in Christ. The antidote to relapse and the necessary tool in my belt and my weapon in my arsenal. The word daily is the key to my success in anything that I do. Okay? My mind can be one of the most toxic places in the world. I must be transformed daily, as Paul admonishes me in his letters to the church. Renewal of my mind is key, and I believe it is for every person, every addict, every Christian. I must surrender my thinking. It is time I must surrender to his way. It is time I must bow to his feet each day. I must grab hold of his garment as the woman with the issue of blood did. She knew her predicament. She knew the desperation of her soul. If I can but touch the hem of his garments, that has to be my mindset, or I will lose somehow. Somewhere today, I must surrender all. What about you, my friend? Our surrender must be in a redundant act. It must be voluntary brokenness, a posture that I assume always as my addiction
as with my addiction, I was dedicated, focused, and surrendered. There is no shame, no guilt in the height of it all. I didn't even care. In this same way, I must abandon myself, my selfishness, and realize that Jesus is my only hope, that he is the great physician, that he is the healer, that he is the source of healing, the healing word in my life. His word of the creator is the creative force that will bring about the change that I so desperately need and crave. I must come out of myself. I must express to God and another man the exact nature of my sins, of my wrong. I must not settle for the implosions in my soul that I have grown so accustomed to. So now that God has used another man to light a fire under me, now that someone has kicked and challenged my complacent behind, now that I have awakened from my comatose sleep, now that I have come to myself and realized that I can and I will do better, that I am a soldier, and that I can rise to new heights in Christ, that I can express myself, that I can share with other men my pain, my anger, my displeasure with myself and others. Now that I am taking responsibility beyond my Adamical tendencies, now I am a man again, a real man, alive and alert to the presence of the Spirit of God, Spirit of Christ that lives in me. I now see the fruits of his Spirit being manifested in my life. I have a sense of gratitude for the healing that is mine today. I will gladly share this with another man, another brother, and I'm no longer trapped in the cobwebs of mindlessness, wondering that whether I have grown so prone. Complacency is the thing of the past, and I have this sense of urgency today. And henceforth, I am my brother's keeper. I am God's man with a purpose beyond just paying the bills, seeking pleasure, and worth it in the end. I can take that take from somebody else weaker than I. I now spend my days reaching out to serve, to give, and I have this sense that God is desiring to use me, to touch other men. I realize that one day I will stand before the King of Kings, and I will give account for all that I've done in this flesh. Paul says, behold, I show you a mystery. You shall not always sleep. You shall be changed in a moment, in the twinkling of an eye. That's it. God can do that. He can change me instantaneously. It is possible on that day. But for now, I must do the work. I must beat this body. I must train this mind. I must reprogram this brain to be healthy, to be mindful of Christ and what he wants from me. I can do this today, one day at a time. I can do this with God's help. And he promises that he will never leave me, that he will be with me even to the end of the age. Come, my friend, I want to tell you today, it is time. It is time for you to break out of your addiction. It is time for you to come out of the secrecy. It is time for you to rise to new level. It is time. It is my time. It is your time. It is the church's time. It is my wife's time. It is my kids' time. It is time for us to become all that God has purposed for us to be today. And so I'm excited. I'm fired up. And I'm ready to go for Jesus Christ. Addictions are broken in your life today. Addictions are broken in my family and my kids today. Rudeness and rebellious spirits are broken in Jesus' name today. I take authority because God has a purpose for me. God has a purpose for you, mister. God has a purpose for you, young lady. God has a purpose for all of us. As we begin to take back our authority, as we begin, to let go of the things of this world, the things of this world will grow strangely dim. Only what I do for Christ will last. I will shoot for the stars, and even if I land up in the clouds, guess what? When I shoot at that high level towards that mark that is in Christ Jesus, the high calling that is in Christ Jesus, even if I miss it, I'm higher than the shooting low and shooting at the ground and missing the target or not having a target at all. Today, I want to tell you today, I want to encourage you today. I just have it in my spirit to encourage you that it is time. While I'm sitting in this traffic, I want to tell you that it is time. It is time for God to do an amazing work in you, but it's a time for you to do a more amazing and disciplinary work within yourself, within your brain. It is time to break free from the Adamic nature. It is time to break free from the programming that we've been offered and given to, and from the dining at the delectable table. It is time for us to break free from being temple prostitutes. It is time for us to break free from religiousness and mediocrity. It is time for us to begin to talk about the down and dirty and dingy and sinful things, because they don't bother God. They don't bother me. They don't bother you. It is the reality of our life. It is time to rise out of codependency and begin to be interdependent, to depend on the King of Kings and the the Lord of Lords. That is what I'm saying to you today. And those of you that hear my voice today, under the sound of my voice, I want to let you know that if you were to die today, and if you were to confess everything to God and to another human being, guess what? You're going to live with him for eternity in heaven. But while you're on this earth, you can live free of pornography. You can live free of an adulterous relationship. You can live free of impure thoughts. You can live free from lustre. You can live free from bondage. You can live free from the addiction. And as I'm moving down this traffic, I want to close up today and let you know that this is the most amazing day of your life. Something good, something amazing is about to happen. And guess what? I need a change. I need a change. I got to break this circle. I need a change. I need a change. I got to break this circle of pain, the circle of shame, the circle of sin, the circle within me. Oh, I need a change today. I don't understand what I'm feeling. Is this a season I'm going through? I got to pack my bags, take up for some country, see something new. Oh, you got to see something new. You got to see something new in Jesus. You got to see yourself set free. You have to have a vision, a clear mental picture of a preferable future in Christ. And that is a future that is full with freedom. That is a future where you leave a legacy. That is a future where you walk with the empowered anointing of the Holy Spirit. And when devils see you walk through, they're going to realize that you get up in the morning with one thing on your mind, and that's to revenge the enemy for all the years that he has stolen, all the pure life that he has stolen away from you. God will restore everything that the canker worm have eaten away. Every agreement I've made from the dark side is broken today. And I'm praying for you today for deep level healing. I'm praying for contracts to be broken in the spiritual realm that men have made. Men that are acting insane and crazy today. Men that are leaving their homes and families and wives for decadent pleasure and selfishness. I break that spirit today in every friend, in everyone who's there, who's listening to my voice. And I pray that the anointing and the conviction power of the Holy Spirit will be upon you. There is healing. There is miracles happening right now in Jesus' name. I want you to call somebody today. I want you to call a brother today, Warriors of Freedom. And I want you to tell them that, hey, I decided today to go free. I decided that it's time. I'm sick and tired of being sick and tired of being sick and tired with no hope and no dreams and no aspirations. I'm getting back into this fight, and God's going to do something absolutely amazing. I'm out. That's it. Period. And I just want to say to you, it's time. That's it. Bye.